Submit my bill, Mr. Kittredge, when I'm finished.
You heard?
I heard.
Well, well, well. Frank Apple.
Mannix, you still won't take no for an answer, huh? I forgot to tell my partner how touchy you are.
Is that your boy throwing lead at me in the garage?
Our side wouldn't have missed. Looks like we'll have to beef up our physical fitness program.
I'd like to try again sometime.
Let's see what you can turn up inside.
Yeah, but you mind if I turn this thing off?
Well, now, just how is the Air Force involved in this case?
Well, I'm not Air Force now. I'm still official, but it's a different agency.
Oh, it's beginning to sound like top security.
You mind if we don't discuss it?
Ed Kovac was murdered, wasn't he?
That's our department, okay?
By Mark Harper.
You're fishing.
The way I've got it figured is the girl was working for Harper and taking information across the border. Did she know what was involved?
Mannix, as a favor to me, to your Uncle Sam and the free world, will you just leave?
Sure. But I do have my license to worry about, so I'll have to tell the police everything I know.
Mannix,
mm-hmm.
We want Harper's name kept out of this.
Well, what's so special about Harper?
He's one of our agents.
Well, now the case is taking on a new dimension. But if Harper was working for you, why would he kill Kovac? Unless he was a double agent.
Mannix, don't make me use muscle. Just keep out of it.
Well, you know, you people are stifling private enterprise. Just trying to find out what's going on.
You'll find out. Just keep watching the news.
I got a gun on her! Get away from those cars or I'll kill her!
Abbott, if he lets her go, you let him drive out of here!
You're quite a shot.
He always was.
George, get on the radio, will you? I want a team out here before the police arrive. We turned up a party membership on Kovac.
Well, he'd hidden Harper's body. Put Harper's body in the car, jammed the accelerator to the floor, and the car drove itself into the crash. Perfect. Except he happened to run through a few frames of film. Kovac's wife didn't know about this, did she?
No. Kovac told her he could explain everything. She loved him enough to believe him.
Look, Abbott, I'll be around if you need me.
So long.
That's my daughter, Lynn, Mr. Mannix. That's Moonfire she's riding, a Tennessee walking horse. I gave it to her for her 18th birthday. She's been crazy about horses since she was a child. This isn't like her, Mr. Mannix. It isn't like her at all.
When did she first decide to enter Moonfire in the horse show?
Last month. She wired the Mission Motel for reservations. It's their confirmation. She left 2 days ago. Tuesday morning, early. It's a 4-hour drive. She had Moonfire in the trailer.
Did she call you when she got there?
Yeah. Yeah, about noon. Said everything was fine and that she'd call every day just before dinner.
Anything else?
Oh, just the usual daughterly things. Well, there was one thing. Well, there was one point where she practically had to yell over the phone.
Huh?
Why? A bell was pealing. It was very loud.
A bell?
It was the noon bell from the mission. She said she could see the tower from her room. And she said she'd phone again when she got back from the riding stable.
But she didn't call you that evening.
No. No, that one phone call was the only time I heard from her.
Mr. Calder, I hate to say this, but I've got to. You're a very wealthy man. You can't rule out the possibility of kidnapping.
I thought of that, Mr. Mannix. But there's been no phone call, no note, nothing.
Yeah, well, I guess you would have heard from them by now.
You know, when Lynn didn't phone the next day, I called the motel. And the clerk who answered said she wasn't registered. That she'd never been there at all. I argued with him, but he was positive.
Why didn't you call the police?
I did. They sent a deputy both to the motel and to the riding stables. They said there was no sign that she'd ever been to either place. It's as though she never existed. Mr. Mannix, you find my daughter for me. I'm terribly worried, and I love her very much. Mannix?
Yeah, speaking.
I have wonderful news.
Well, I could use some.
Ben is home.
What?
She's home, safe and sound.
That's all we ever wanted, wasn't it? To get your daughter back home? There's only one problem. I don't believe it.
Mr. Mannix, it doesn't really matter what you believe.
You mind if I talk to her?
I don't want to wake her. She's completely worn out.
No, you wouldn't have to wake her, Mr. Calder. I'd just like to see for myself that she's all right. Would you mind showing me to her room?
I couldn't do that.
Because she isn't upstairs, is she? They got to you, didn't they, Mr. Calder? They put the squeeze on you to get me out of their hair. Mr. Calder, do you honestly believe that you've bought back your daughter's life by taking me off of the case? The men you're dealing with have $1 million riding on his caper. They won't give your daughter a second thought. All you've done is bought back a couple of days.
Don't say that.
They can't afford to let her live to identify them.
No.
Mr. Calder, by taking me off of the case, you've played right into their hands. Don't you realize what you've done? Signed your daughter's death sentence.
Flight 47 to St. Louis. Oh, you're booked under the name of Montgomery.
First name?
Frank. You'll be staying at the Shoreview Motel. There's a payphone about 100 yards up the road. We'll phone you there every other night at 11 o'clock.
I see you've thought of everything.
We've had detectives on this before. Whoever's been stealing our industrial designs has always been tipped off.
Does anybody know me at your St. Louis plant?
No one.
Let's keep it that way.
TWA flight number 47 for St. Louis is now ready for boarding at gate 31.
Well, guess that's Mr. Montgomery's flight. Gentlemen.
Good luck, Mr. Mannix.
Flight 47 for St. Louis is now boarding at gate 31. Passengers, please check in.
What do you think?
I'm betting a $100 million company we have the right man.
What does fishnet mean to you?
Mr. Mannix, you aren't supposed to be seen here. And you look terrible. What's wrong?
Look, one man is dead, another one's dying. What happens now depends on your help.
You're serious?
Yeah.
Well, do I have a choice?
You can tell me or you can tell Washington. If you wait to tell Washington, you could end up accessory to murder.
What do you want to know?
Everything.
Well, fishnet is a sensing device for missile defense. We produce a small silicon segment here and ship it on for assembly.
Where?
No idea. Military picked up our first prototype unit early Monday morning.
Monday. Monday. One more question. Why did you hire me?
Well, I explained all that.
No. I mean me. Why not Mike Hammer, Sherlock Holmes, or someone?
Well, your name came up at a board meeting.
Who suggested it?
I don't remember.
Well, find out.
Miss Jacobs, get the minutes of our last board meeting and find out who suggested Mr. Mannix's name to us.
Yes, sir, Mr. Hammond.
What's the matter with you?
There's too many candied apples.
Can I get you something?
No, thanks.
Mr. Hammond?
Yes?
It was Thomas Ferguson who suggested Mr. Mannix.
Art, it was Thomas Ferguson. Mr. Hammond, get him in here.
He left this morning for a few days.
Where does he live?
225 Oakstone Drive. What is it?
A friend of mine just died.
I'm sorry, Mr. Mannix.